What is up, Measure friends? This is Eric from Measure School. Did you know that more than 90% of the world's internet users uses a mobile phone occasionally? Or that more than 60% of the world's internet population uses a mobile device to go online? And I'm not making that up. You can check this on Statista and even Data Reporter. And let's not forget that Google prefers mobile-friendly websites, as you can see with the mobile-first indexing. And what that means is that when it comes to indexing and ranking your website, Google will first look at the mobile version of your website. Well, all this means is that dashboards and reports for mobile are an obligation if you value your user's experience and user retention. In this video, we'll see how to build mobile-friendly dashboards in Looker Studio and strategies for mobile audience targeting. Let's get started. I am now in the report editor in Looker Studio, and some of you may be thinking, alright, there must be a button hidden somewhere that can help us make our dashboards mobile-friendly, right? No. This option is not available yet in Looker Studio. Therefore, we'll be looking at two ways of making our dashboards mobile friendly. First, we'll be looking at how to build them from scratch. Initially, we need to know what is the best screen size resolution to design for. And for this, we need to know what is our target audience. We'll be looking at some tools to find this information. And then we'll be looking at important design concepts. The second method to do this is actually a quick and dirty solution which involves CSS code. And don't worry if you hear code, because you can achieve this in less than a minute if you follow through. Alright, let's do this. In the report editor, we need to decide now what is the best screen resolution to design for. Ask yourself two questions. Do you want to optimize for your target audience, or do you need to optimize for the whole world? Let's cover target audiences first. Target audiences are your users who are the most valuable to your business, or who meet your specific criteria. But how to figure what mobile screen resolution they use? You can use your analytics platform like GA4 to answer that. For example, in GA4, go to your reports and head down to tech and select overview. Scroll down and you should find this card where you can see users by screen resolution. Screen for designing dashboards can go from 360 pixel wide to 400 or 414 to be precise. As you can see here, the most popular screen resolution is this one, which has 390 pixel wide, and we are interested in the width and not the height. Now we can look at more details by going here, and we'll have a more detailed report for our screen resolutions. Again, here now you'll see all your screen resolutions, and we can find again our mobile screen resolution here. If, for example, you have difficulties finding it because you maybe have a lot of desktop users, simply add a secondary dimension, go to the plus sign, and select platform device, device category, and then look for mobile. You can find here. It is worth mentioning that you should also optimize for certain regions. So if you know that you have users that come from a specific region for your target market, then you can add them in. You can also achieve this by removing your secondary dimension, and let's add a new one. Select geography and country. The good thing with this is that we can now analyze our screen resolutions to see which screen resolution brings in the most users, for example, or which ones have the most engaged sessions, or are the most valuable in terms of conversions or revenue. You can also achieve the same by building explorations in GA4, which I have already done here. And here I have just added a filter with an exact match for mobiles. If you want to optimize for the whole world, or if you have information to share with the general audience, or maybe if you don't know your target audience and you need to figure it out, you can go to Google and type stat counter. Select screen resolution. Now go to the website, and here you'll find screen resolution statistics for all devices and regions. Here you can select a device, and here you can select also a country that you are interested in, or worldwide. In our case, we'll go for mobile. And here I have mobile screen resolution stats worldwide. Now make sure to select the top line here. And as you can see, the most used screen resolution has 360 pixel wide. Okay, so we are going to rebuild this dashboard in Looker Studio. I assume that you already know how to build basic ones on your desktop, but if you have any problems following along, just know that we have a video on how to build dashboards in Looker Studio, so check that out. Now we need to figure out what will be the pixel width. And again, we have decided this by looking at our GA4 account and selecting 390. Now head over to your canvas and here go to theme and layout. Now in layout, make sure that your navigation type is set to hidden. And then make sure that the display mode is set to fit to width. All right, now we can add in our pixel width. Go here and look at the canvas size change. All right. Now, don't freak out if on the view mode you notice that this has been magnified. There is no issues here. I'll change the theme and layout and let's select the Edge theme. And now we are ready to start building our dashboard. Let's go. I'll add a shape. Now let's add our logos. I'll add my other one. Perfect. Select them both. Go to Style. Make the background transparent. I'll resize this. This as well. Good. Now, one thing to know about mobile-friendly dashboards is that you do not want to overcrowd them. So in comparison to maybe the versions that you have for your desktop, here you want to do your best to summarize data and keep only what is essential. And one good way to do this is to use scorecards. So let's add a scorecard. I'll build this out. Change the metrics to total users. I'll add a comparison. For the comparison date, and let's select previous period. I'll duplicate this, the size. All right, I'll change here, select our total revenue. Perfect. Now we'll add our date. So we add the date range control. And the issue here sometimes is that when you decrease the date range control, you'll notice that we are left with something here and it is hard for user to understand really what's going on. So here's a trick. Let's use a shape. Let's change the background of our shape and set it to transparent. I'll change also the border color and go for white. Resize this. There you go. Let's add some text. Select your text and let's change the font color to white. Let's resize this. And perfect. We can now add our actual date range control. And what we'll do now is to change the style, change the opacity, and set it to 0%. And bring this over on top. Now users can go and just select their date range. Let's add a line chart. This way we can see how our users trend over time. Size this. Now let's add some text. Right. Now let's change our date range. I'll go for March of last year. And let's have 1 month of data. Great. Now hopefully this gives you an idea of how to build those kind of dashboards in Local Studio. Now let's see how those will look on mobile. I'll go on view mode. And what you can do now is just go on this white part here at the top, right click and select inspect. And here we can see how this will look actually on mobile. You can also change the responsiveness here and go to the width. We had 390. We can test this out. Let's change this also, for example, to 360. Fantastic. Another addition to your mobile-friendly dashboards is to have menus. So here you can have a menu to give you some inspiration where users can hover and click on these links. Here's another type where you actually have a menu bar. Now let's see how to embed our dashboards. To do this, you'll head over to File, and in File, go to Embed Report, and then select your code here. I have embedded this here in a WordPress web page. The only thing I'll maybe let you know is you should add here center, one at the beginning and another one at the end, and make sure here to add the forward slash to mark the end of the code. This is the result that you should have. Alright, let's look at one last method. The difference here is that you will not have to build a dashboard from scratch again. Here we have a full-on dashboard for desktops and we will force it to be responsive. To achieve this, we will cover a fantastic tip shared by Elliot Millichamp. And here we'll only have to add some HTML and some CSS. Let's look at how to do this. Back in Local Studio, we will want to embed this report, so go to File and then Embed. And copy the code. Paste it in your web page builder. Here, the only difference is that you'll have to add this div container and also close your div to the end. Now, in your div container, make sure to rename this part with anything that you'd like. Here it is Google Data Studio. Now, we'll look at how this looks on mobile. So I have embedded this. Let's see how this looks on mobile. Right click, inspect, And as you can see, the dashboard is still the same. It has not been made responsive. And this is because we did not add the CSS code. Now, if I was to go back, and let's go back to website here, copy this code, and let's paste it. Now, pay attention. The naming that you have for your div container has to be the same also in your CSS code, as you can see here. All right. Now, if we were to preview this, now we have our dashboard, and you can see that it has been magnified a little bit more. Let's right-click, go to inspect, and there you go. You can see now that the dashboard has been made responsive. So this method will work perfectly if you don't have much data on your dashboard. Otherwise, you'll still have to zoom in when you use your mobile. So this is why we covered the first method by building a new one for mobiles only. We come to the end of this video, and if you got any value from it, please consider liking the video and share your thoughts with us. In any case, thanks for watching. This was Eric from Measure School, and see you next time.